Hello students, welcome to SGT classes. In this video we are going to discuss about miscellaneous exercise 2 and problem number 6. Hum is video mein miscellaneous exercise discuss karne wale second and the problem number 6. So let's start from the problem number 6. The diameter and the height of a cylindrical tank is 1.75 meter and 3.2 meter respectively. How much is the capacity of tank in liter? Okay, the pi is equal to 22 upon 7. Okay, this is given. So what is given? Diameter is given, the height is given. Diameter is 1.75 meter and the height is 3.2 meter. So first we need to find out the volume of the tank. पहले हम लोग को volume of the cylindrical tank find out करना पड़ेगा and then we'll get the capacity of tank. Okay, so what is given? First we'll write the given things. Okay, so what is given? The diameter is given, p is given. Okay, it is 1.75 meter. Okay, therefore r is equal to what? D upon 2. So it is 1.75 upon 2. Okay, so we'll keep this value as it is. Therefore r is equal to 1.75 upon 2. Okay, and this is in meter, this is in meter. Okay, so this is the value of r. And second thing is given. What is given? Height. H is given. H is given 3.2 meter. Okay, so first the volume of the cylindrical tank. Therefore volume of cylindrical tank, cylindrical tank, what is the volume of cylinder? You know that pi r square h. Okay, this is the volume of the cylindrical tank. So now we'll put the given values. Okay, 22 upon 7 for the pi. Okay, it is given. Into r is what? 1.75 divided by 2. 1.75 divided by 2. Into h is equal to 3.2. Okay, so 7 ones are 7. So take the 0, 7 twos are, okay, 7 twos are 14 and 7 fives are 35. 0.25. And this 2 into 2, it is 4. Okay, so first we'll divide by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are, okay. Again 2 ones are and 2 8s are. So now what is remaining? 22 is remaining. In this case 0.25 is remaining. Then 1.75 is remaining and 0.8 is remaining. Now do the calculation. Okay, so this 25 into 8, so it is nothing but 200. Okay, so now 25 into 8, 8 5s are 40s are 0.4 and this is 16 and 20. Okay, so this is nothing but 200. Okay, but what is there? The condition is, see how many points are there. 1 point and this 2 means 0.2. This is 0.2. Okay, so it is 22 into 0.2 into 1.75. okay, so 1.75 into 2. Okay, 2 5s are 10s are 1, 15s are 5, you carry 1 and this is 3. So this is 3.5. okay, so 1 2 and this 3, so 0.35. okay, this is 0.35. so 22 into 0.35. okay, again 35 into 22, 2 5s are 10 and this is 70. okay, 0 and 7, this is nothing but 77. okay, so now how many points? 2. So 7.7. okay, so this is given in meter, so meter cube, it is meter cube. Okay, so volume of the tank is what? 7.7 meter cube. Okay, remaining will write here. Okay, so this is the volume of the tank. Now the capacity of the tank. Okay, so you know that 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. Okay, 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. Therefore capacity of tank, okay, capacity of tank, okay, in liter, okay, tank is equal to what? 7.7 into 1000. okay, so it is 7700 liter. Okay, 7700 liter, this is nothing but the capacity of the tank. So first find the volume of the cylindrical tank. It is 7.7 meter cube. Okay, and then you know that 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters, so multiply this 7.7 by the 1000, so you will get the capacity of tank. Okay, so what is the capacity of the tank? 7 1700 liter. This is the capacity of tank, which has the diameter 1.75 and the height 3.2 meters. Okay, so very easy. First of all, write the given, then use the formula of the volume of the cylindrical tank, pi r square h. Put the values to the calculation, you will get 7.7 meter cube. Now 1 meter cube is equal to what? 1000 liter. Okay, so multiply by 1000 to 7.7, you will get 7700 liter. Okay, so this is the problem number 6, and now we are going to solve problem number 7. Okay, this is problem number 7. The length of the chord of a circle, okay, is 16.8 cm. The length of the chord of circle is, the length of the chord of circle is 16.8 cm, radius is 9.1 cm, find the distance from the circle, okay. So we need to first draw the circle, okay. So we will draw the circle first. Suppose this is the given circle, okay. So what is given first? See, the length of the chord is given. Suppose this is the chord AB, okay, and its length is 16.8 cm, okay. And now radius is given. Suppose this is center of circle, this is suppose O, okay, and the radius, this is nothing but the radius of circle, radius, okay. It is given 9.1 cm, okay. So the radius is given 9.1 cm. So length of chord is given, what is, 16.8, and we have to find out this. Suppose this is M, okay, and this make 90 angle, you know that it is a perpendicular bisector, okay. So this is total length is 16.8 cm, okay. Total length is what? 16.8 cm. This is given. So if we divide this, okay, if we divide this 16.8, then we'll get 8.4, okay. So this distance is 8.4 and this is 8.4, okay. So like this. So what we have to now do, we have to just do the construction. So let O be the center of circle, okay. O be center of circle, and okay, OAB, OA is equal to radius is equal to 9.1 cm, okay, and AB is equal to what? Chord is equal to what is this? 16.8 cm, okay. This is given, this is given, okay. So now you know that the perpendicular, okay, the segment drawn from the center to the chord, bisect the chord into two equal parts, okay. So we can use that property, the perpendicular, okay, perpendicular drawn from center to the chord, okay, to the chord, bisects it, okay. So this length AM is equal to what? Therefore AM, okay, length of AM, okay, length AM is equal to 1/2 into length of AB. So it is 1/2 into 16.8, so it is 8.4 cm, okay. So now see, this is nothing but O is the center, O is the radius, AB is, okay, like this. So in triangle OMA now, okay, in triangle OMA, okay, angle OMA is equal to 90, okay. See this, OMA, okay, is 90. Therefore by Pythagoras theorem, what is this? OA square is equal to OM square plus AM square, okay. So OA is what? 9.1 square. Then OA square, okay, we have to find out OM. AM square is equal to 8.4 square. So now first find out the square of 9.1, okay. So 91 into 91, okay, 1 and 9, take the 0, 9 ones are 9 and it is 81. So 1 8 2 8, so it is 82.81, okay. See, 9 ones are 9 and 9 9 is 81, okay. So 1 8, then this is carry 1 here, okay, so what is this, 2 and 8, so this is nothing but 82.81, okay, then 8.4 is there, so 84 into 84, 6 is 6, carry 1, now 84 is 32 and 33, okay, 84 is 32, 2 and now 3 is remaining, 88 is 64 and this 7, 4 and this 3 is 7, 67. So now what is this, 650 carry on, 70.76, so OM square, then what is this, 70.56, okay, therefore OM square is equal to 82.81 minus 70.56, okay, this, so do the subtraction, 82.81, 70.56, so area minus 6, 5 will be the carry 1, it is what, 2 minus 0, it is 2 and this is 1, 12.25, therefore OM square is equal to what, 12.25, okay, okay, so OM square is equal to what, OM square 12.25, so taking square root, okay, therefore OM is equal to what, 3.5 centimeter. So this OM is nothing but the distance between center and the core. Okay, so the distance, what we have to find out, find the distance from the center of the core. Okay, therefore the distance from center, okay, to the core is 3.5 centimeter. Okay, this is nothing but the solution. Okay. Okay, so first in this diagram you have to draw the circle, then take the center, then draw the radius, then draw the chord, okay, then draw the perpendicular, okay. So this perpendicular is nothing but the segment joining center to the chord, is nothing but the distance of center to the chord, okay. So now use like this, and then what you have given, let O be the center of circle, O is the radius 9.1, AB is the chord 16.8. Now the perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord, bisect the chord, okay, so this is 16.8, it is 8.4, okay, so now this length AM is equal to 8.4, so now take the triangle, okay, this triangle OMA, it is right angle triangle because this is perpendicular, okay, so now by using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to the addition of two remaining sides square, okay, so AM square plus OM square, so now take the squares of these two, okay, and then do the subtraction, then by taking square root of this 12.25 you will get 3.5, okay, that is nothing but the square root of the 12.25, and that 3.5 is nothing but the distance between the chord to the center, okay, or center to the chord, okay, and that is nothing but the final solution of the given problem. This is the 7th problem. Now we are going to solve 8th problem. Okay, this is the question number 8, okay, and the part A, okay, there are 4 villages and the number of female workers and number of male workers given, okay, and we have to draw 2 graphs of this given information, okay, so first is the subdivided bar graph, second is the percentage bar graph, okay, so now first we are going to draw the first subdivided bar graph, okay, so what is given? There are 4 villages A, B, C, D, okay, and there are some workers under the scheme of the employment, okay, or the scheme of the work guarantee, okay, there are some workers, okay, in that 4 villages A, B, C, D, okay, 4 villages mein workers hai, some are the female workers, some are the male workers, and just so A, B, C, D, these are the 4 villages, okay, and we have to add these, okay, A and B. Okay, so female male total, and we have to represent this all information in the form of the subdivided bar graph. Okay, so we need to draw these 2 axes. First is x axis, this is x axis vertical, and this is horizontal x axis, and this is vertical y axis. Okay, so these are the 2 axes. Now, so this y axis 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, 350, 400, 450, okay, so these are the number of workers, okay, at 1 centimeter 50 workers like this, and on the x axis these are the number name of the village A, B, C. Okay, so first case 150, what are the 150 are the female workers. So this information is the female workers and remaining are the male workers. Okay, 225. In the second village 240 are the female workers and remaining 160 are the male workers. And in the C village, okay, only 90 are female workers and remaining 210 are the male workers. And then in the last case D, okay, 140 are the female workers and remaining, okay, remaining what, the 110 are the male workers. So you have to just divide the given information. Okay, so you need the total. Okay, what is the total? 375. So first you have to draw the column of the 375, okay, like this for the A village. Then it divide into two parts, 150 for the female and the remaining 225 for the male. Okay, and this information is here. Okay, this is the male workers. In the same case, in the second, 400 is the total. So draw the bar of the 400, then divide the 240 female and 160 male. Okay, this is second. And then third, 90 is and 210. Okay, this is 300 total. Okay, so draw the bar of the 300, then 90 are the female and the remaining are the male. Okay, what, 210. And the last one is same, 250. This is the bar of 200 and these are the female and these are the male. Okay, so this type of representation of the given information, okay, in which there are two parts, okay, subdivided, okay, one part for the female workers, one part for the male workers. And this type of bar graph is known as subdivided bar graph. Okay, so these are the number of workers working under the scheme of whatever they, okay, and that is nothing but for how many villages, from four villages. Okay, some are the female workers, some are the male workers, and you have to just do the total and just divide that the bar into two parts. One is the female workers, one is the male workers, and this type of bar graph, okay, you have to draw. So this is known as subdivided bar graph, and this is the A part of the given information. Okay, this is the first bar graph, subdivided bar graph, and now we are going to draw the second type. What is that? Percentage bar graph. Okay, this is the B part of the question number 8. We have to draw again the second bar graph. It is nothing but percentage bar graph. So what is the given information? Number of females, number of males, then total, percentage female and percentage male. We have to first find out. Okay, so how to do, you know that this percentage male, okay, and percentage female. Okay, so percentage female, okay, so we know that the number of females, what is 150, then divide by total number of males and females, 375 into 100. We have to proceed like this. Okay, so now 25 fours are, then 25 ones are, okay, what is remaining now here? 17 remaining. Okay, 25 ones are. Okay, so 25, I minus this, okay, 37 minus 25, so there will be 2 and then 125. Okay, and 25 5s, okay, so 50 ones are, so this is 10. Okay, so now 10 into 4, what will be there? 40. Okay, so this is nothing but the 40% female in the first case. So remaining percent will be male. Okay, 40 female are 40, then out of 100, 40 minus 100, 100 minus 40 is 60% male. Okay, like this. So in every case we have to just find out first. Okay, we have to find out the percentage female, then automatically we will get the percentage male. Pehle hum log ko percentage female nikalna hai to male apne aap mil jayenge. Okay, so second case you can see this is 400 total. Okay, percentage female, so it is 400. Okay, what is the total number of females? 240 divided by total number of male female, okay, into 100. So 0000. Okay, so 4 ones are 4, 4 6 are 24. So 60% females, then 40% male, like this. Okay, so first you need, okay, we need to draw this chart. Okay, this is chart. So this chart, in the first case 40% female, 60% male, 60% female, 40% male, 30% female, 70% male. Okay, just do the calculation. Okay, so percentage, okay, how to do percentage? Number of females divided by total number of male female, okay, into 100. Number of females divided by total number, number of female, total number of female, into 100. Okay, so you will get these numbers. Okay, 40, 60, 30, 56. So 40 female, then 60 male, 60 female, then 40 male, 30 female, then 70 male, 56 female, then 44 male. Okay, then we have to draw this graph. Okay, 10% 1 centimeter, okay, on the y axis. Worker 10% means 1 centimeter is equal to 10% workers, 10, 20, 30, 100, okay. So these are the hundreds columns, okay. So this type of bar graph is known as percentage bar graph, okay. Now this is x axis, this is the y axis, okay, x and y axis, okay. So these are the 30, these are the 20, okay, these are the 10. So now we have to just divide these hundreds bars, okay, into two parts, 40% female. So where is 40? So this 40, okay. So these are the nothing but the females, okay. And these are the males, females, males, okay. Then second 60% female, okay, 16, where is 60 here? Okay, so 60% female, okay, like this. So divide that hundreds bar into two parts, okay. These are the male, these are the female, these are the female, these are the male. Then third case in the C village, okay, 30% female, okay, 30 is here, okay. So like this, 30% female, okay. And the last case 56% female, this is 50, so it will be here approximately, okay. So like this, so this type of bar graph, okay, is known as percentage bar graph, okay. So on the x axis villages ABCD, on the y axis 1 centimeter is equal to 10% worker, okay. So what you have to do, first you have to write the T1, number of males, females, then total male, female, then percentage of female first you find, okay. So number of females divided by total number of males and females, okay, into 100, you will get percentage of female. So whatever the percentage there, minus that percentage from the 100, you will get the percentage of male, okay, like this. So just you first prepare the table chart like this, then draw the each column to 100, okay. Then half part will be female, whatever the percentage, that much females will be there, remaining male, female, male, female, male, okay, like this. So you have to draw the bar graph in the form of hundreds column, okay, and then divide into females and male, okay. Such type of bar graph is known as percentage bar graph, okay. And this is the 8th question, okay, second part, okay. And the 9th question we'll discuss in the next video, okay. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.